Last week, CNN's Alisyn Camerota spoke with a panel of former 2016 Donald Trump voters. All of them happen to be suburban women, that demographic that Donald Trump swears is totally going to vote for him. And they all kind of told the same story. And this actually happened 2 weeks ago as well with CNN. Held a panel with these former Trump-supporting white suburban women, and they have abandoned him. But one of them actually said something, and that's kind of what I want to talk about right now. And she said that Trump has destroyed the country in a way that no other president has done before. You know, she was shocked at the amount of devastation, the amount of damage that Donald Trump has actually done to this country in just 4 short years. That statement is why Donald Trump's claims of Joe Biden unleashing anarchy and only Trump being able to keep you safe, that statement is why Donald Trump's, you know, fear-mongering isn't resonating as much as it usually would with these voters. He's the one who causes the chaos. He is an agent of chaos. He revels in it. He enjoys it. He encourages it. And the voters, at least some of them, you know, we don't really know yet how widespread these feelings are, but some of them totally understand it. They get it. And that's not even the most important part. The most important part is the irony of it all. We have gone through decades of Republican candidates for House, Senate, and President telling us that if we elect the liberal, if we elect their opponent, that person is going to single-handedly destroy this country as we know it. It'll never be the same. The country you know, the country you love will be dead. And you might be too. They've told us that. And Matt Gaetz told us that at the Republican convention last week. He said, if you vote for Biden, boom, you're going to have MS-13 moving next door to you. Well, it turns out it's the Republicans. They're the ones who have actually been destroying this country as we know it. None of the dire predictions that Republicans have been making for decades have ever come true. You know, there's just the widespread abortions everywhere. An abortion clinic on every corner. Never happened. In fact, abortions actually go down when Democrats are in charge. That's quite an amazing statistic. When Republicans are in office, abortions go up. They've never come door to door confiscating your guns, even though we've been hearing that for decades. My whole life, Republicans have been saying Democrats coming door to door to take your guns. It's never happened. Never. Death panels. Well, we have them now, actually. Had to. Because of the pandemic. We had doctors and nurses and hospital corporations having to get together to decide which person's going to get the last ventilator. Who lives, who dies. It's a death panel. The thing Democrats would do, they actually caused to happen here in the United States. All of the big, horrible, bad things, you know, Democrats are going to trash the Constitution. Democrats are going to take away your rights. All of those horrible things they said would happen under Democrats have happened under Trump. You're losing your rights. They are taking peaceful protesters off of the streets and arresting them. That is violating your First Amendment rights. They are taking peaceful protesters sitting on the ground, gassing them, tear gassing them, pepper spraying them. That's a violation of your right. Hell, that's a violation of the Geneva Conventions. If it happened in another country, we can't do it to other people, but we can do it to ours, sure. It's insane. So that's the great irony of all of this. Everything they said the Democrats would do, they've actually been working to do it. And that is to destroy this country as we know it and to rebuild it into something that truly is terrifying. And that is what this little CNN panel last week was talking about. They kept telling us the Democrats were going to do it. But the second they got power back in Washington, D.C., the Republicans went ahead and did what they'd been warning us Democrats would do for decades. And they did it in less than 4 years.